Hello friends, welcome back to our channel Physics and Animation. Today we will talk about the following topics. Number 1. What is lead acid battery? Number 2. Constructional detail of lead acid cell. Number 3. Chemical action during discharging of a lead acid cell. And number 4. Chemical action during charging of a lead acid cell. So let's start. What is lead acid battery? The battery which uses spun lead and lead peroxide for the conversion of chemical energy into electrical power. Such type of battery is called a lead acid battery. The lead acid battery is most commonly used in the power stations and substations because it has higher cell voltage and lower cost. Constructional detail of lead acid cell. The most common parts of any type of batteries are: Number 1. Positive plate. Number 2. Negative plate. And number 3. Electrolyte. Positive plate of a lead acid battery is made of a lead peroxide, PbO2, having chocolate brown color. Negative plate of a lead acid battery is made of a spongy lead, Pb, having dull gray color. The electrolyte used in the lead acid battery is a solution of sulphuric acid and distilled water in the ratio of 38% of sulfuric acid and 62% of distilled water by weight. Now let's move forward and talk about the working and the chemical reaction taking place in the lead acid cell. Chemical action during discharging of a lead acid cell. A load is connected externally between these plates. In diluted sulfuric acid, the molecules of acid splits into positive hydrogen ion and negative sulfate ion. The hydrogen atom moves to the lead peroxide plate and reaching the lead peroxide plate receives one electron from the lead peroxide plate and becomes hydrogen atom. The hydrogen atom comes in contact with the lead peroxide, so it again attacks lead peroxide and forms lead oxide and water. And then this lead oxide reacts with the sulfuric acid which forms whitish lead sulfate and water. The each sulfate ion moves towards the lead plate and reaching there gives up two electrons and becomes radical sulfate. As the radical sulfate cannot exist alone, it attacks the metallic lead and forms lead sulfate, whitish in color. As positive hydrogen ion takes electron from lead peroxide plate and negative sulfate ion gives electron to lead plate, there would be an inequality of electron between these plates. Hence, there would be a flow of current through the external load between these plates for balancing this inequality of electrons. Or we can say that the potential difference is created between these plates. Chemical action during charging of a lead acid cell. For charging, the anode and cathode are connected to the positive and the negative terminal of the DC supply. The molecules of the sulfuric acid breaks up into hydrogen and sulfate ion. The hydrogen ions, being positively charged, moves towards the electrode connected with the negative terminal of the DC supply, and each hydrogen ion receives electron from there and form a hydrogen atom. The hydrogen atom react with the lead sulfate of cathode, forming lead and sulfuric acid. Now, negative sulfate ion moves towards the electrode connected to the positive terminal of the DC supply, where they will give up their extra electrons and become radical sulfate. This radical sulfate reacts with the lead sulfate of anode and forms lead peroxide and sulfuric acid. After charging the lead acid battery, now it is ready for discharging. Thanks for watching, friends. Please don't forget to like our video and subscribe our channel, and also press the bell icon so that you will be notified whenever we upload a new video.